Yeah.
Why the circumcision? Why the dedication? Why is that in the text so strongly? We're right back at the concept of law.
Yes.
It might not be Jewish law, but it's law. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, with that in mind, another thing I'm going to show you. We call the covering of the Torah the mantle. Now, imagine this. If I was to read this Torah now, what do I have to do with it in its current state?
Remove the mantle.
Remove the mantle. Now, what's that significant thing that the two significant things you mentioned that get that happens to Jesus in the Gospels, that like we're asking, why is that mentioned? There's two things, right? The dedication and there's the circumcision. Now, I don't know if you've ever seen in a traditional synagogue when it's time to get the service going, you'll see that somebody gets the honor every service to literally walk around the synagogue like a crazy excited person holding the Torah scrolls above their head. Why do I do it in front of people? If you think about it, why am I doing it in front of people?
With the sports trophy, you'd be doing it to show them that you won it.
Right. I love the word you used. Show them. Now watch this. Remember, we're staying in legal space. For me to justify what we're talking about, I have to keep on pulling it back into legal space. What is the connection between the word you used, showing it, and how showing it appears in a legal context, in a courtroom? What's the overlap?
Evidence.
Right. And who needs to see the evidence?
The judge, the jury, the both side, the prosecution.
Right. And what's the critical element that can either set a potential suspect free or condemn them? Witnesses. Why would we stand in a synagogue and lift this up?
To show
honoring
them.
It? Yes.
To show it.
Showing it? Because
yeah.
Guess what we're doing? We're making people, we turn you into a witness. Isn't that interesting? So if I display something, it's I'm making you a witness to what I'm displaying. Why did you and your wife not get married in a dark room somewhere secretly?
Yeah, because we needed witnesses.
You have witnesses. What does the rabbi or the pastor at the service inevitably do? He puts you in front of everybody. Everybody has to watch.
Yeah.
Everybody sees your wife come down, your bride come down the aisle. Everyone watches that. You stand, you don't go and do this in a back room somewhere. You give your vows in public.
Yes.
The witnesses you chose are supposed to be the ones that actually verify your marriage. They're the ones that... That paper you sign has got no value if there's not witnesses that can say, we saw that happen.
In fact, when my bride and I got married, we had to do a legal courthouse wedding because we were in Germany and we didn't have an American pastor who officially had the license and all that. So we went to the German courthouse and they told us, you have to bring witnesses or we won't do it.